training team, I'd like to welcome you to Orca Encounter. Being a part of SeaWorld's mission is more than just a job. We are proud of what we do. It is a privilege for us to care for, build relationships with, teach, and learn from these amazing animals. Now more than ever, we are honored to share our relationships with the whales and what we have learned with all of you. We hope you enjoy Orca Encounter!
These behaviors keep our whales active and engaged. SeaWorld's killer whales have inspired generations of guests to care about our natural world, and we're excited to share their story with all of you here today.
Predator. They use cooperation and communication, not just size and strength, to take their place at the top of the ocean's food chain. At the bottom are small animals, like krill. At the top, the apex predator, the killer whale. Faster than an Olympic swimmer.
weeks, months, years, building relationships with our whales. This creates trust, and that allows us to do some amazing things. For example, when you visit the doctor, you present your arm to draw blood, or step on the scale so you see how much you weigh. It's much the same with our whales.
Today we'll see the whales moving together in unison. These synchronized behaviors strengthen social bonds and enable them to problem solve as a group. Working together as a team is what makes them the ocean's top predator. Scientifically known as Ursinus morca and commonly called killer whales. Here at SeaWorld, we refer to them as Katina, Melita, Yolani, Trua, and Makayo, our killer whale family. Makayo is our youngest whale. He actually celebrated his 13th birthday yesterday. Yeah! And his mother, Katina, is our oldest whale, and this year she's celebrating her 47th birthday. Katina is also the matriarch or leader of our pod. SeaWorld's animal training techniques create a language between us and the whales. It's a language of learning through positive reinforcement, encouragement, commitment, and care. Through these techniques and our relationships, the whales learn to trust us. They even learn to take an active role in their own health and well-being. Now, we train our whales using positive reinforcement. So every time you see a whale do a behavior correctly, you're going to see a trainer blow a whistle. That means good job, and you can get some kind of reinforcement when you come back. That might be fish, it might be ice, it might be a rub down. There's a lot of different ways we can reinforce our killer whales. Now in this environment is Trua and Makayo. So Makayo, the birthday boy from yesterday, and then Trua is 17 years old. Trua weighs about 8,000 pounds, and he's still growing, so is Makayo. Makayo weighs almost 6,000 pounds, so you'll notice a little bit of a size difference. Now, in just a moment, we're going to get to see one of the very first healthcare behaviors we train our whales, and it's called a voluntary blood sample. Our whales will learn to roll ventral or upside down, and they'll present their tail. This not only gives us a great look at their entire body, but it also gives us access to easily see blood vessels on the white undersides of their tail fins. Now, Nick has given Trua the hand signal to roll ventral, and you'll see he's slowly presenting negative with his tail fins right there. You might be able to see a very thin vein along the white underside, exactly where our vets can take a blood sample from. Now, we take a blood sample at least once a month, and our whales are trained to remain calm and relaxed throughout the procedure. You may notice some of our trainers rubbing or massaging on the whales, whether on their backs, pectoral flippers, or tail flukes. The whales have very sensitive skin, and this is just one way we can reward them for remaining calm during procedures like this. It's also a great way for us to strengthen our relationships with whales. Now, taking a blood sample is just one way we can make sure that our whales are staying healthy. Another important diagnostic is weighing our whales. We're able to weigh our whales by asking them to slide their bodies up and out of the water onto a killer whale size scale. Now this is Makayo demonstrating this right here in our slide out. You'll notice that the space between its dorsal fin on his back and his tail fins are still in the water. That's called the peduncle, and it's the powerhouse of the whale. It's very muscular and very heavy. With the peduncle still in the water, we wouldn't be weighing the whole whale. So we simply ask our whales to lift their tails up and out of the water. Training this posture enables us to ensure accuracy. So we know that our younger whales are growing properly and that our older whales are maintaining a healthy weight.
And the care isn't just physical. Mental stimulation and play are vital. And we surprise and engage our whales at every opportunity. Play is how killer whales teach their young to hunt. And for the adults, play is important too. It seems that they just enjoy having fun. Making time for play is an important part of life for killer whales and for us.
So killer whales learn a lot by playing. They also learn through observational learning and mimicry. From the moment they're born, killer whales learn necessary life skills by playing follow the leader with their mothers and other whales. Our whales play follow the leader with us too, and you all are going to get to play that game with them today. So center of the stadium, it's going to be your turn first. Everybody stand up for me. We're going to play a game of killer whales. Spin in a circle two times. Ready? One, two, three, spin! And they've got it! Well done, everyone! That was amazing! You all can have the So when he comes out of the water, give him a big round of applause.
One choice.
One positive act.